Welcome to this teaching learning of mining machinery. I am Professor Khanindra Pathak. I teach mining machinery, surface mining and environmental management in mines. So this course of mining machinery is to introduce you the operations, constructions and maintenance of this mining machinery which are deployed in different types of mining, surface mining, underground mining, in coal and metal sector. As you know, the mining today is facing new challenges because of all these easily accessible seams are now over. So under difficult mining conditions, to do a cost effective mining, we'll have to be very careful in selecting proper set of machinery, and also there will be need of developing new set of machines and mechanizations. So to this end, this course will help you to understand how mining machinery is deployed in the mines and how to be managed, how you will be managing technology involved in these machines. So for that purpose, you will have to know the trend of developments of these machines. At the same time, the electrical and mechanical aspects of this machinery, and I hope this course will give you a new insight into the way the big machines which are deployed in our mining sector. So you will be learning very high capacity machines, as well as you will be learning the transportations of these machines through different modes, as well as how you will be stocking these minerals in different storage facilities. So overall, the production, transportation, storage, for all purposes, how mechanizations have been serving the mining industry will be exposed through this course. And this course will be a totally your interactive learning. You will have to interact with different learning materials. The course will also help you in going through your self-testing, and through different assignments, you will be practicing whatever you will be learning. I hope this course will give you a interest in various operations in mines, and hope it will help you in getting a good footage in your future career. So, welcome to this Department of Mining Engineering, where we deal with mining. What we mine is, you can see over here some of the rocks and minerals. That, as you know, that our whole aluminium, whatever you are using, that aluminium is coming from this type of rock, which is just a bauxite rock. And then you know that our all cement buildings and all everything is coming from this, our limestone is the source. Similarly, we have got this granites. You may be seeing a lot of building floors and all with granites. This is coming, this type of rock. The earth is endowed with different type of rocks. And also, sometimes you can see this marble, whether it is a sandstone or we have got the fossil fuel coal. You can see this coal which are mined over here from the earth. Also, all the source of your steel is this hematite, which we are mining in our Tata mining at Unnamundi. Similarly, different gemstones, you can see a piece of amethyst here, where you may, many of the ladies may be wearing their garments made of these stones. Or sometimes for your home decorating, you may keep a sand rose in Tunisia. Such type of sand roses are available. You keep some perfume over here, your whole, your drawing room will be giving a good fragrance of this. These are things. And also when we look into the art, sometimes we discover what are the old ages. You can see a fossil rock, how it is there. So this world of rock, from there to go deep into, we need to sometimes do the drilling. There are different type of components of the drilling were there. So you can see here that drill machines with different type of bits you will be learning in the mining machinery, as well as there are different type of surface mining machines are there. In this course, you will be knowing details about how this type of hydraulic excavators or this motor grader, dozers, different type of dumpers, they are working in the real industry. Nowadays, the development of this type of trucks are now operating with 540 ton capacity. You can compare, our road trucks are only 12 ton capacity, and that 540 ton capacity trucks are operating in the mines without man. That is automated trucks, which are the development of the mining industry. So in this course, you will be learning many of these machines in a how they are exactly working in the field and how they are manufactured, how their developments have taken place. So this is just a mini to show that to have your interest in this particular one, because whatever machinery we'll be doing, whatever rock we'll be handling, ultimately it is going to serve the mankind. Our people, whatever our daily everyday needs, all are coming from the different types of rocks in the earth. Welcome to this laboratory. This is the laboratory for learning about the basics of mining machinery. So here, though we start learning from that what is a gear to what is a bearing, from there to applications of different machinery. You can see the drilling machines over here. That is a setup for experimenting with jackhammers. We also teach about that how the engines work, that about automobile engines. We also teach about this how in the mine the pumps, there are different characteristics of pumps, it is determined. So this is because of management of water in a mine is one of the very important things. So in this laboratory, we do these experiments with all this equipment. At the same time, we teach our students how to use the hydraulic circuits. This is a hydraulic trainer. In this trainer, we train our students about the different controls used in the mining machinery. So that is a, similarly, we have got a, that other side, you can see that there is a electro-pneumatic trainer. In those trainer, we use that students make different type of circuits and they study the control characteristics of machinery. Students are given here tasks to learn different types of gears, and then they learn about these gear trains and the gear box, and they do some small experiments to know about the basics of this machine's gear system, the power transmission system. Then they learn about that how automobiles work and automobile engines. They do some basic understanding with the differentials, and in that they learn about the normal general day-to-day functions of different engines and automobiles. Also, they study different type of characteristics of materials for the handling characteristics. We have got the for bulk material handling purposes. Also, you can see here that we have got a big slurry transportation system, the transportation with slurry. They study about the storage characteristics of materials, and then how to design different types of that storage bins, gates and all that experiments they do here. In this experimental setup, we teach them about the bulk material handling, particularly the transportations. In the mine, we have got different types of rocks for their transportations. We face different type of situations. For that, this particular setup is bringing almost all types of conveyor belt. From the top, you can see that there is a storage at the top of it. From there is a flat belt conveyor over there, which we can have an apron conveyor. We have got a chain conveyor here, in that which is also a, which can go up and down, that is your, with a different inclinations, a chain conveyor is there. There is a trough belt conveyor, and also we have got a high angle conveyor over here. So that students do experiment with that, what is that exactly the the power, motor power required. So there are different sensors are also loaded over here that when the material is going, they do the proper sensing, and we have got that exactly the panel from where they study about the different power requirement, different control, different emergency switches which are there, all are in this particular setup. And by about 3-4 experiments the students can do over here for understanding in the mines how exactly the bulk material is transported for different conditions. So this is here we do not have yet another thing, that new development of pipe belt conveyor, but for before conveying, the materials are handled by different, so we have got some of the basic material handling equipments are also here for crushing and grinding for that purposes, for particularly for mineral processings. We have got some of the very basic understanding of it, science and technology for material handling. We have even the students do experiment with this type of setup for understanding the how exactly material get transported by chutes or by in which way they can be exactly improve their performance. So that by doing something, and this is the laboratory where the students are allowed to do work by themselves, then they do a lot of work, and then many of the work we do in our this workshop. From the workshop they fabricate different units, and this gives the students exactly to learn by themselves by doing. This is the basic undergraduate students initiating to learn about the basic machinery so that they can do the advanced analysis of machinery, and then the advanced learning from the machinery, that basic concepts are given in this particular laboratory.